Hello, my name is Jan. I'm from CB Software. We are working on a psychological horror game, which is called Someday You'll Return. And it takes place in our country. The goal of the game is that you are going to find your missing daughter. And she's not missing because she would get lost. She's missing because she's actively running away from you. So that's kind of the basic premise. You have like a smartphone app tracker for her smartphone and you just go there and pick her up. Doesn't get so simple eventually.
Okay. So can you go into detail like how big is your studio or how much people are working on the game?
Yeah, we are actually a two-man studio. We are based in Brno and we are doing this game for 3 years. Already next year we want to finalize it.
Okay. The environments and the engine are really good looking. What are you using? Is it Unreal Engine or?
Yeah, it's Unreal Engine 4.
Okay. So I played a bit the game. It kind of reminded me of some games like Outlast. Are there some games you draw inspiration from?
Yeah, definitely Outlast could be one of them. Although we are trying to be more like, it's more like a symbolistic game in a way. And also, of course, Silent Hill 2 is kind of big inspiration if you don't count the combat, because we don't have a combat in the game. Mm-hmm. But a lot of inspiration there. Also, Vanishing of Ethan Carter or What Remains of Edith Finch. But in our case, we really have kind of more involved gameplay with the crafting and stuff like that.
So what platforms and what release time can we expect?
Yeah, we will release this game on PS, PS4 and Xbox One. Mm-hmm. And hopefully next spring, something like second quarter could make a sense. Depends if we manage to finish it.
Okay. So I noticed that there are some voiceovers already missing in this version. Could you go into detail with that? How are you going to implement some voiceovers, or do you got a team for that?
Yeah, actually the voiceovers will be done by a British studio called Omuk. They are the guys behind, for example, Horizon Zero Dawn and these kind of games. So we already have this organized, but it will be recorded next year.
Okay. So could you go into detail some gameplay elements? What can people expect from the game?
Yeah, there are many different game systems. I mentioned the crafting, but it's like not like just a basic combining of items, but you just basically have to build things. You have a hammer, you have a screwdriver, you have to mount things, dismount things, like a 3D thing, 3D system. Then you can pick some plants and mushrooms and brew more or less poisonous stuff you have to drink in the game. There are some kind of environmental puzzles, so you basically have to interact with the environment, change it somehow. There are some, let's say, sneaking things that you have to be very stealthy in certain passages. You have to climb rocks, so basically find a way around on the rocky walls. Mm-hmm. And also, for example, you have a smartphone where you basically can reply to people. There's like a karmic system which traces how you react and how you work in the game. Also, we have some NPCs. It's not like just the forest, but you meet more or less weird people in the forest.
So NPCs, can you interact with them or?
Yes, yes. Okay. We have like a dialogue system, which is one thing where you can interact. But the dialogue system is not interactive itself. It was my decision because with two people, it's hard to make like this consequence system, which will really make sense to make some tree. But you interact in other ways with them, and sometimes you have to lead them through certain parts of the game and help them get their goals done. So,
Is there like a red string through the whole story, or is it possible to go another way or change the direction?
Actually, the game is kind of semi-open world, so the beginning is kind of very linear, and at certain point you decide how you want to go. And but the for example, there are multiple endings, but they are not depending on your progression through the story, but more about how you play the game, how you behave as a character.
Mm-hmm. That sounds awesome. Is there maybe a final question? Is there something you're really excited about? Maybe something, a gameplay feature you implemented, or?
I think the most excited I'm about the fact that when people play the game, even this slice, they really tell me we are immersed. We really want to know what happens next. We really want to experience this, and for me this is basically maybe the thing I'm excited the most, because all the gameplay system, they just serves for the narrative, and in my case I'm really happy that I can see that people are actually not thinking it as an obstacle, you know, just stop playing, but it's more that they feel enhancing the story. So that's my favorite thing about the game.
Yeah, it sounds awesome. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much for this interview.
This was supposed to be easy. Just track her down again and bring her home. I had no idea how wrong I was, and how far I would really have to go.
Search for the missing girl continues in the DVD.
Please, tell me that she's safe.
Your hysterics aren't helping. Stop calling me.
Ugh.